Hey guys, Halfway Dead here, with a long-awaited controller input lag comparison. I usually don't do this at the beginning of the video, but I have to give a shout-out to my patrons, because this video would have never happened if it wasn't for their financial support. I've already talked about how I'm testing in the previous input lag videos, so I'm gonna go straight to the results for the average input lag measured. For comparison, I turned the Arduino itself into a controller first and rated all the other controllers relative to it. The fastest controller I tested is the DualShock 4 when used with a Bluetooth connection. The Steam controller has about twice the input lag on a button press. At 1 millisecond more, there is the Xbox One controller, which performs essentially equal with a wired, Bluetooth or wireless stick connection. Another 1 millisecond on top is the result of the wired Xbox 360 controller, as well as the analog stick of the wired Steam controller. At 10 milliseconds delay, we have the DS4 wired, 7 milliseconds slower average input lag than Bluetooth. But make sure to watch on. The DS3 controller also has 10 milliseconds delay on analog input, but an extra 3.5 milliseconds on button presses. The wireless version of the 360 controller performed a lot different from its wired version, with a 10 millisecond button press and 12.5 millisecond delay for analog inputs, 3 and 5 more milliseconds than wired. The Steam controller had an increased delay of 5 milliseconds with the included dongle and over 7 milliseconds when using Bluetooth. Alright, those are the results for the average input lag, but there are a lot more aspects that need to be discussed. First of all, for all wireless results, I want to state that I had a Wi-Fi router within 1.5 meters and a phone about half a meter away from the controller. I tested every setup with a controller receiver distance of about 10 centimeters, as well as 3 meters, and found no measurable difference in any of those experiments. You still want to keep in mind that my results may have been impacted by some interference, which is a trade-off that you usually have to make with wireless. Another important aspect in input lag, mainly for Rocket League or rhythm games, is the consistency. Input consistency is worth its own video, but as a short example, the following should suffice. When you fly at the ball to shoot it, there is usually that one perfect moment where you want to dodge to get the shot with as much power as possible. Let's say my controller can either have 0 milliseconds of latency or 20 milliseconds. Basically, I can try to hit it at the perfect time for 0 milliseconds of lag, or I could hit it at the perfect time for 20 milliseconds of lag. Or I could hit it right in between. In the first two cases, I would have a 50% chance to hit the perfect shot, and a 50% chance to hit a shot that is off by 20 milliseconds. In the third case, I would hit a shot that's off by 10 milliseconds every time. This controller would have an average input lag of 10 milliseconds. But let's say there is a controller that always has 15 milliseconds of input lag. As long as I'm able to estimate when exactly I need to press the button, I could hit the shot perfectly every single time. That's the theory. We're all incapable of hitting the perfect shot 100% of the time, which is why a better player on a worse controller will still do better power shots than a bad player on a good controller. Nevertheless, I wanted to mention this because this is exactly true about the DualShock 4 controller. It has 7 milliseconds less input lag over Bluetooth, but a more stable connection over cable. The best way to show this is in a density distribution graph. The amplitude of the graph shows how often your inputs will arrive with that much delay. The wired DS4 has a 4 millisecond uniform block with a bit of noise around it. The 4 millisecond window is a result of the 250 Hz wired polling rate, and the noise comes from the limited game frame rate and tiny fluctuations in frame rate. With Bluetooth, the DS4 uses a higher unstable polling rate of around 700 Hz, which causes the narrow peak, which is great. However, there are quite a few results in the 20 plus millisecond range, which is why it has a higher standard deviation overall, and as such is less consistent. Why on earth's name Sony didn't allow 1000Hz polling over USB when the controller is clearly capable of it, and why there is an input lag difference that big that can't be explained by any logic, I wish I knew. The DS4 overall is still the winner of both lowest lag as well as most consistency, depending on the mode you're in, but it could have been crushing. When it comes to consistency, the Xbox 360 controller is the next best ahead of the Xbox One controller. That was surprising to me, since they both have 125Hz polling rate. So I took another look at the density distribution and found that the wired Xbox One controller does for some reason not show a uniform distribution. Instead, the possible lag values show a Gaussian spread much further than necessary. When connected wirelessly or over Bluetooth, it didn't have this issue, but similar to the DS4, some very high samples ruined the consistency. The wired Steam controller was somehow worse despite also having a 125Hz polling rate. Wireless made it slightly worse than wired, but with Bluetooth it had by far the worst consistency out of all experiments. Do not use the Steam controller over Bluetooth if you don't have to. The DS3 only sends 100 reports per second and performs as expected, the worst out of all wired controllers. Now there's still software left to talk about. What about X360 CE, Durazno, DS4 Windows, and of course the Steam controller configuration? I initially started out by testing Steam's configuration and found 1 millisecond of extra input lag, which doesn't seem bad at all if you consider what you can get out of it. I also found that for some reason with the wireless DS4 and only that, it caused 3 milliseconds of extra input lag. After that, I started testing every controller, wired and wireless, with every compatible software, only to find something rather surprising. The only configuration software that caused any measurable input lag at all was that of Steam. It makes me quite hesitant to recommend it now, but it's not a massive difference, so if you're running fine with it, then you can keep going. But Durazno can also square the analog sticks, and DS4 Windows and X360 CE have most of the features you could ever want. It should be mentioned that the DS3 doesn't work natively, so I had to use SCP Toolkit. Therefore, I couldn't determine if it causes much input lag. But there was a setting called Use Asynchronous Hit Report Processing, which reduced the input lag by less than half a millisecond. This video might have been the biggest project I've ever made. From ordering and opening all the controllers, figuring out how to connect them, to measure them with my Arduino. Taking around 100,000 measurements total, to organizing and visualizing all of the data at the end. And all I've done so far is determine the input lag of these controllers. I have plans to test some more, most noticeably the accuracy of the analog sticks. I've already found some, under certain circumstances, noticeable differences. It wasn't an objective measurement though, and I don't want to release any results that might be an incorrect feeling. I have some ideas on how to do proper testing, but if you think you have a good idea, it could definitely help me, so put it in the comments. Once again, shout out to my patrons, without whom this video would have been impossible. If you appreciate the kind of work I do, then you can support me at the link on the screen and get some benefits in return. To stay up to date about the channel and Rocket League, follow me on Twitter or join my Discord, and I'll see you soon for the next video.